The U.S. Department of Agriculture is announcing $145 million in funding for 700 loan and grant awards through the Rural Energy for America program, or REAP, to help agricultural producers and rural small business owners make energy efficiency improvements and renewable energy investments to reduce energy costs, generate new income, and strengthen the resiliency of their operations. Energy technologies eligible for the loan and grant awards include wind, solar, renewable biomass, ocean, geothermal, hydroelectric, and green hydrogen. Projects that combine solar and storage are also eligible for funding. What exactly is a solar and storage project? Tony Jimenez, a researcher at the National Renewable Energy Laboratory in Golden, Colorado, explains.
Solar and storage project, and maybe another term slightly more precise would be PV and storage, since solar can include solar thermal and concentrated solar, is basically a renewable energy installation that includes both the PV system and a storage component, almost always some sort of battery, most commonly these days lithium ion. You can certainly get PV and storage separately. They're often acquired together.
He talks about what types of locations and businesses are best for a solar storage project.
The motivations to install solar may be a little bit different than for storage, so I'll address those separately. For PV, common motivations are going green, desire to produce one's own electricity, and monetary savings. Sometimes you can get all of those. Sometimes there's trade-offs. For electricity, PV is the easiest distributed-scale renewable energy technology to deploy and can be deployed almost anywhere. Storage can be deployed almost anywhere. It makes most sense when there's a concern about resilience, if there's a lot of power outages, that sort of thing. Monetary savings are another common motivation, although it's harder to get those with storage at current prices, absent some sort of grant. So behind-the-meter storage typically will not totally pay for itself. What you often see is a combination of motivation. So it might be both resilience, and somebody will put in a battery for resilience purposes so they can ride out a power outage and say, hey, I got this battery, I can use it to manage what I pull from the grid and maybe get some bill savings. And so at least it can get some bill savings with it, but probably not enough absent a grant to totally pay for the battery. But they do have the resilience benefits, so they are getting more.
Jimenez offers tips for drafting a proposal for a solar and storage project.
You want to look at first when sizing the PV. A good maximum size for the PV would be the system that produces about as much as the annual consumption. If you go way bigger than that, it should have a good reason. For storage, a way to look at it is hours of autonomy. So basically, you take your average load, so basically your annual consumption divided by 8760, which is the number of hours in a year, and compare that to your energy storage capacity of the battery. For example, if you have a battery with 10 kilowatt hours of storage and an average load of 2 kilowatts, that gives you about 5 hours of autonomy, and that's kind of a good metric to think about how much storage you want. Typically, the larger the load, the size of the battery relative gets smaller. So for example, if you have a residential system that's grid connected, you might go up to maybe a day's worth of autonomy. If you're talking a large commercial, say several hundred kilowatts or megawatt scale, might be 1, 2, 3 hours.
Agricultural producers and rural small business owners who want to learn more about renewable energy concepts can visit the National Renewable Energy Laboratory's Energy Basics page at www.nrel.gov/research/learning. Anyone interested in applying for USDA's REAP funding is encouraged to contact their local USDA state energy coordinators for more information. Interested applicants can also visit rd.usda.gov, enter Rural Energy for America in the search box. Remaining application windows in 2024 end on June 30th and September 30th. Reporting for the National Renewable Energy Laboratory, I'm Chad Smith.